All right. Hey, Doc, you know, I was thinking about it. This is the 24th year in the row that you and Eileen have come to our house during the Labor Day weekend.
24?
Yeah. You know, I don't know what started it. Or I guess we invited you to spend the Labor Day weekend with us.
We didn't just drive in.
It was in 1996, I think. Mm-hmm. And so, 24 years. 24 years. This is 24th time that you and Eileen have spent the Labor Day holiday with us.
Right.
I think it just started off with a long weekend, but soon after that, it just graduated into a week.
Blossomed.
Yeah. You know, I've always looked forward to this time because I consider it to be Christmas of the mind. We've just had such stimulating conversations over the years. Just learned so much.
Why don't you unwrap today's idea?
We've had a great time.
Yeah, we have.
I remember walking on the beach with you in Virginia Beach.
Yeah.
We'd go out at night and just walk the beach when we lived there. That was fun. So, anyway, hey, I've got a bunch of questions I want to ask you. I think some others are going to be interested in hearing. You up for it?
Go ahead. I don't know what you're going to ask, but you go ahead.
All right. Well, Doc, you are known as the guy in the world, the top guy on the resurrection of Jesus. You've been studying this for a long time, haven't you?
That I have, because I'm an old guy, that's why.
When did you start studying the resurrection, and what led you to start doing it?
Well, it's a little embarrassing to say so, because people think, what can you do when you're young? But I started having severe doubts when I was 13 years old, and I tried a lot of paths. People said, try this, try this, try that. And pretty quickly, it occurred to me that if Jesus was raised from the dead, that's a lot of potential. So I settled right there.
So you were 13.
I was.
You were a Christian at the time.
I was.
Doubting whether Christianity was true.
Pretty severely.
And you determined that if Jesus rose from the dead, Christianity is true, and that's why you started studying it.
Right, but I just had no idea if there were any data that would actually fit the bill.
So, was that your own thought about going with resurrection, or did you hear it from someone else?
No. People said, check out creation, check out archaeology. Did you hear they found Noah's Ark? Hey, what about the future? Things look like it's coming true. And I just listened to those things. I thought, yeah, interesting, but none of them, you know, fit the bill. And then I was reading a book one day, and the guy said, if Jesus is raised from the dead, you know, it makes sense that what he taught was true. And I just thought, yeah, that's the best answer I've heard so far. So I kept reading.
So you studied it a lot at that point. Like how much did you study it? What happened? How did you go about it?
Daily. I mean, I played a lot of sports, hockey, football, and my afternoons would be occupied with that. And when I came in at night, it was like, okay, what did I leave off last night? So it was kind of a mixture of sports and seeking, studying.
Wow. And so how long did you study for, and what was the end result?
At a time?
Yeah. Not at a time. Like, did you look at the evidence for a week, a month? How long?
Years. Like, years on the resurrection.
Like, how long? How many years?
Well, after 2 years, I stopped and I wrote an essay I was 15. I wrote a 25-page essay. And it wasn't to show anybody, look what I've done. It wasn't for a class. It was for me to give me a total listing that I could go back for a quick reference system.
That's pretty cool. So, did you want to become a scholar at that time? What was your goal in life?
Didn't give it a thought. I tell people, I wished I could be altruistic and say, yeah, I did this for people who have questions. I didn't. I did it for me because I had questions. It was very selfish.
Wow. You know, when I was in high school, my senior project in English class, my 12th grade senior project, we had to do a project. I chose the resurrection of Jesus.
Right.
And so I did a little research, nothing like you had did at that time. Put a few weeks into it, created a, they didn't have PowerPoint back then. This is 1979. And they had one of these things, what do you call those? It was like a round...
carousel?
A carousel. And you make slides.
Yeah.
Slide projector.
That's an early PowerPoint.
Yeah. So somehow, I don't even know how I did it, but I made some slides, put together a senior paper, turned it in. It was public school, Baltimore County Public School, Lock Raven Senior High School. And I got a C on that paper.
A C?
A C. And the my English teacher said, "You didn't prove anything."
How'd it make you feel?
Not too good. And then I had people in the class call me Reverend Mike. But, you know, that's interesting. So,
well, did you take it like a put down, or did you take it like, well, this
no,
is cool?
It was a put down.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, it was a put down. You finish high school, what happens next? You go into college? Are you studying resurrection at that point?
No, because you know how your first few years of college, you study general topics, and you're just told you need so many hours, you need this, and this, and you're taking class. It was a secular college.
Okay, and so you finished that up. Now, what are you wanting to be at that time? Do you know?
I transferred halfway through.
You want to be a hockey player? Or?
Played hockey. I transferred to a Christian school. And I'm sure if you would have asked me, I don't know how specific my plans would have been, but I would have told you I thought I was preparing for the pastorate. Yeah, I would have said I thought the Lord wanted me to be a pastor.
Cool. So when did that change?
Well, I wasn't... That was just a conviction of helping people. It had nothing to do with my studies, because my studies were to get me over the hump to know if there was anything to pastor about.
Were you still doubting?
Oh, yeah. I doubted for years and years.
What do you think about that? Is, like, in retrospect, now I know we've discussed doubting over time.
Right.
Is it okay for a Christian to doubt?
Well, yeah. I mean, you can take things too far, but you can take things not far enough, too.
Yeah.
We have issues. If you want to know about truth, if you want to know what where the data are, you have to study.
Cool. So you're wanting to help people somehow. You're wanting to get over the hump.
I'd like to.
So,
but I didn't know where I was.
So you finished a master's degree?
I did. At the time, when I got my bachelor's degree, I thought, okay, well, maybe not. Now, I was already, when I was 20, I was working with youth in a church. But when I got my bachelor's degree at 22, I was hoping that was the end of the road and that I was going to be a pastor and I wouldn't have to go back to school. But then I kept pushing. I thought, well, maybe professors in my future. And I went to the University of Detroit and did an MA in philosophical theology.
Okay. And when you finished that, were you wanting to be a professor then?
I thought about it, but my dad was a business professor. He actually taught a course in resume writing. He helped me. This is the joke of it. He helped me write a resume. And I sent it out to a whole bunch of nationwide schools saying, "Hey, y'all, do you need anybody with an MA? I'd like to teach philosophical theology or something." And they all wrote back, some nice, some rather pointed. "Heck no, we don't teach that stuff." You know, that kind of stuff.
So when did you decide to go for a doctorate?
Well, I took a year off after the MA. I wanted to go straight through, but I just didn't have the gumption to keep going at that point. And I was pastoring. So I didn't want to pastor and do a PhD at that point.
Yeah.
But then I thought, well, everybody's telling me no. Do you want to do it or not? So I just took one step at a time and... to show you how one step at a time goes, I applied to Michigan State, and when I become a PhD candidate, I thought, maybe I'll stop here. I'll just tell everybody I'm a PhD candidate. I mean, it's legal.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, got to push some more. When I was a PhD candidate, I sent out 225 resumes.
Oh.
Schools all over the U.S. Even, I remember sending one up to Alaska.
That's a cool place.
Well,
literally.
I didn't do it because it was a cool place, yeah. I did it because I was interested in teaching. I wasn't getting a lot of bites. So progressively, I'm thinking, darn, I've got to finish. So I kept working.
Yeah, that's cool. So you eventually get a teaching position. Now you've been teaching for 40 years or so?
Over 40.
Wow. And you're at Liberty University. You've been there for how many years?
About 38, I think.
Oh. Which is, I know your PhD program is pretty decent. And, man.
Yeah, our guys are publishing. Our guys are getting book contracts like crazy.
That's good to hear. And because I've always said that, you know, I'm at Houston Baptist University proudly. And, you know, when we find students who just can't make it, for some reason or another academically, at HBU, we're happy to send them to Liberty.
Ah, and we're happy to refuse them.
Well, thanks a lot. Appreciate your thoughts on how you progressed on this, and thanks for all you've done for study on the resurrection. You've certainly been an inspiration to me.
Well, thank you so much. The crazy thing is, I wasn't trying to be an inspiration to anybody else. Just trying to answer my questions.
Awesome.